for a lot of people, talking about sex can sometimes be a struggle. But today we are stripping back the taboo so you can talk to your partner with total ease. Joining me now is certified sex therapist Kristin Hodson. And you brought props.
I brought props.
You brought props.
It just makes it so fun.
Sex.
Right.
I love it. All right, tell me about how sex and dining have something in common.
So what I have found as a sex therapist is people are, they can talk about all sorts of dining, like if they want to go fancy food, if they want to do something drive-through, what they want to eat, they can talk about that way easier than they can about sex.
Well, it's easy to discuss it. Well, what are you in the mood for?
Right.
What type of food sounds yummy to you? And
right.
You come up with somewhere to go pretty easily.
Pretty easy. Or you're like, you know, I'm not totally hungry, but I'll join you. Mm-hmm. And we have all this flexibility around eating and dining, but then when it comes to sex, we tend to get pretty rigid mm-hmm. and pretty like, oh, no, it has to be this way. But if we can expand it like we do with our dining, it can be more fun, more pleasurable, more fulfilling.
Okay, what are we looking at right now on the screen? That was a menu that you actually created.
Yes.
But it's not a food menu.
Not a food menu. It can be a guide to help people start to figure out what they want with their sex life. Like, people just kind of have sex and expect it should just happen. Mm-hmm. But when we start to talk about it and be like, well, what do we want? Like, what do we want for our foreplay? Or think about the classic scenario when people are done having sex and then they just roll over. Mm-hmm. And like, how about some dessert for our sex?
Okay,
like, let's have some aftercare. Like, what do we want here? And so
it. This
menu can be used in a variety of ways of like a fun and flirty, like, slip this under your pillow. It could actually be a conversation.
Be something that you actually go through with your partner
yes.
and discuss. Let's start with some of your tips. So number one, you mentioned this drive-through versus seven-course meal.
Okay.
There are two kinds, or more than two kinds.
Because really, like, if you think about it, the movies likes us to believe that the best sex is seven-course fancy dining.
Mm-hmm.
I would die if I had to go to a fancy meal
every
single
day of the week.
Right. In the same way, like, sometimes I just need drive-through fast food,
mm-hmm.
but you can't just live on that.
What about
either?
Snacks? Do we ever just need like a little snack?
That's the thing. So I brought this because if all of our sex is just snack food, like just these quickies, then that's also not going to be fulfilling either. So you have to have balance, like Chili's,
mm-hmm.
huge menu. Most people can find something they both like on it. That mm-hmm. might be your staple.
Mm-hmm.
But then you have this flexibility of fast food, fine dining,
go to like snacks, every once in a while.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay,
exactly.
I love it. Hungry versus willing to eat. That's your second comparison here. And this
yeah.
is one that I feel like is so true.
This one's so important because at times it's like, I don't ever want to have sex if I'm not just absolutely feeling it. But how many times have you gone and you're like, I'll sit down and someone gets fries and you're like, oh, can I
have
one of those?
Of
and then before you know it, you're like, oh, I'm
you've
just
eaten their whole McDonald's
yes, and you're
fries.
Yeah. Hungrier than you realize. And so sometimes if we're just willing to engage with our partner like we do dining, then we can start to get turned on and aroused and start to get hungry.
So it takes like a little appetizer or a little taste of something.
Right.
And then from there we see how we feel.
Have a beautiful meal.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, and that brings us to the next point, which I love, enjoying different things on the menu.
Yes, because so let's say your husband ordered chicken. You probably mm-hmm. weren't like, ew, you ordered
I'm not judging
chicken.
You because...
Right, it's like, oh,
you
got chicken, and I'm a vegetarian, and so we figure out how to make this work, but like our sexual choices, sometimes we'll want one thing, and they'll want another, and we'll be like, ew, instead of being like, tell me more about that.
Like, why did you
like about that? Or tell me what it would mean to you, or what would that be like, or how do we figure this out?
Mm.
And so when we don't judge what we want sexually, like we don't our food, we can learn more about our partner and be more intimate.
So, okay, I have a question with this. What happens if I am a picky eater? Like, maybe I'm happy for you that you chose the chicken. I don't want it. So how
right.
do we how do we do that? Do I take a courtesy bite?
You could take a courtesy bite, or if you're like really appalled at chicken, there's all these other ways. Like, again, if you go to Cheesecake Factory, so many other menu options that when it comes to sex, we can get really hung up on what we don't want or what we don't like or what we can't have instead of focusing on all the things we do want
mm-hmm.
and we can have.
And
so start to explore that
ground.
Stuff. Yes.
So many like insightful points that you bring today, and I'm so happy you were here. Kristin has a fabulous Instagram account that I swear I learn something new every day on. It's dedicated to all things like sexual health and education. She's at Kristin B. Hodson. And I just love it. Really took off fast. You only started this, a couple months ago, maybe?
Yeah, it's been funny. I guess people want to talk about sex.
They do. Let's
so
talk about
good.
Sex.
Right.
Can you come back again?
I would love to.
I love it. I'm glad you were here. All right, Brian, I don't know now. Like, I know I'm hungry. I don't know if I want fast food or like high, but I know whatever's coming up in the kitchen, it's going to be good.